come join us here at the CabaRay.
That's the Ray Stevens CabaRay and Showroom right here in West Nashville. We're easy to find at the Charlotte Avenue exit off I-40 West. It's the place in Nashville for a special entertainment and dining experience. There's great food, all your favorite wines and mixed drinks, a fun piano bar where you can sing along and dance. And there's the Ray Stevens Show, where I'll sing all my biggest hits with Nashville's best musicians and singers. So whether it's a special date night, entertaining friends and family, or you're just coming out to sing along in the piano bar, whatever your reason, the CabaRay is a fun place to enjoy a full night of entertainment. And the parking is free. So come see me, Ray Stevens, at the CabaRay. Call 615-327-4630 or go to raystevenscabaret.com. Make your plans now.
And now, from the Ray Stevens Studios in the heart of Music Row in Music City, USA, it's Ray Stevens' CabaRay Nashville.
My heart keeps going back to Nashville. That's the only place for me. My love is waiting there in Nashville. Nashville, Tennessee.
With Ray's cat, Baillie and the Boys. And the A-Team. And now, the man with his own encyclopedia of comedy music, that's Ray Stevens.
Step right up, folks, and see little Egypt do her famous dance of the pyramids. She walks, she talks, she crawls on a belly like a reptile. Step right up, one thin dime, one tenth of a dollar. I went and bought myself a ticket. I sat down on the very first row. They pulled the curtain up and then they turned the spotlight way down low. Little Egypt came out strutting wearing nothing but a button and a bow. And a diamond big as Texas on her toe. She let her hair down and she did the hoochie coochie real slow. When she did that special number on the zebra skin, I thought they'd stop the show. How it's done. Did a triple somersault when she hit the ground. She winked at the audience, then she turned around. She had a picture of a cowboy tattooed on her spine, saying Phoenix, Arizona, 1969. Yeah, but let me tell you people, little Egypt doesn't work there anymore. Busy mopping and taking care of shopping at the store. Cause we got 7 kids and all day long they crawl around the floor. Singing.
Yeah.
Ooh, yeah, baby.
Yeah.
You know, it looks like you might need to change your diapers. I wonder who we're gonna get to do that. Ain't gonna be me, I'll tell you that. I'm warming your Bible for you right now. Well, that's about all I can do. I'm with Donald Trump on this deal, you know what I'm saying? Yeah.
Kitchy, kitchy, kitchy.
Oh, yeah. We got a lot of fine entertainment for you from Music Row right here in Music City, so sit tight. We'll be right back before you know it. Once upon a time, not long ago, there were a couple of boys trying to break into the music business up in New Jersey. And then they met a girl named Kathy Bailey. And one of the boys married her, and they both joined her in a new musical act that made and set a lot of records as Baillie and the Boys. And they all lived happily ever after and performed on the Ray Stevens Nashville Show. Welcome to the show, ladies and gentlemen, Kathy Bailey and Michael Bonagour.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Well, now, what have you folks been up to lately?
Well, first of all, we're going to just, like, clear up the name. Remember, Baillie and the Boys is what we were signed as, and we became just Baillie and the Boy because the other guy left, so.
Well, it serves him right.
I know, right?
I was going to play along with it, though, because I thought maybe you guys... knew something that I didn't know, and he was going to come charging in here later.
We always play with it, but this is my husband, Michael, so that's cool.
Okay.
You know.
Well, so, people were starting to talk. You know, you live in the two
guys. I know, right?
Guys.
I know.
Let him talk.
But what have we been doing? Still touring and everything, you know, doing what we love, and we're really lucky to be able to do that.
So you're still recording, too, huh?
We are. In fact, we have a new CD that's out right now, and it's called Designated Driver.
It's called How About What?
Designated Driver.
Now, there's not a song on there called Designated Driver, but that's what we're going to call it.
I knew a guy one time called Cooter Brown. He had a tattoo on his arm said, "Please don't let me drive."
Well, I think we're going to call that Designated Driver because I always have to drive because Michael falls asleep when he drives.
That's what you get.
I'd rather drive than drive with him. Are you kidding me? Gosh almighty. You know.
Well, how do you travel? I mean, when you're on the road, cars, bus, plane, what?
All of the above. Sometimes you feel like you don't travel. You just sit at the terminal waiting for the planes to come back in.
Oh, wow. You know, tell me about
that. Happens.
Trying to get to the gig. You do eventually make it. But, yeah, and we travel as a family. Our daughter is on the road with us, too.
Yeah.
And sometimes. And, you know, we just have fun. We have a little band that we've had for 35 years.
Well, I got to hand it to you. Mm-hmm. If you can keep traveling in today's environment, and I'm talking about transportation now, not getting to the gig, but transportation. Bobby Bear once said, "They don't pay me to come and sing at the show. They pay me to get here."
That's the truth. That's absolutely the truth.
I got to hand it to you if you're still
Besides, we love what we do so much, it doesn't ever feel like work once you get on stage.
That's right. Yeah.
It's just getting there and getting set up and making sure everything is right. You know, that's
we
the
had
challenge.
Our own tour bus for 25 years.
Yeah.
And not having it anymore, it's horrible. You know, it's like your little house. You only need this many clothes.
We thought if we put it up for sale, it would take years to sell because that's what everyone says. It takes so long to sell a bus. We sold it in the first day.
Well, you know, today I never owned a bus, but I fly usually.
You were smart.
What?
To never own one, you were smart.
Yeah, well, the thing is, I've been renting them, but lately you can't rent one.
No.
They're all booked up.
They're all done.
All the political tours come to Nashville and rent the buses for the politicians. Did you know that? Yeah.
I'm thinking we should be drivers. Well, there's where the money is.
A designated driver.
See?
I had to get it in.
Wow, that was good.
Okay. I noticed you did an unplugged album recently. Is that just the two of you?
That was, It's more than just the two of us on there. We put together a compilation of all of our demos that we actually had before they became the songs we went in the studio with. Some of them were recorded on a cassette player or a work tape, and some of them were a little bit more elaborate than that. And it's turned out to be such a great selling CD for us. And we put a few songs on there that never made it onto the album. But for the most part, we just grabbed a whole bunch of different tracks we had laying around that we always used to love to listen to when we put them on there.
I want to hear that because I've always thought that a lot of times the demo's better than the record.
Oh. You know, there's something about a demo. When you first write the song, there's
an energy,
because
you're not thinking about it. You're
feel.
Just doing
it's, right. You know, it's the magic that creates the song as it comes out. And sometimes you don't get the same magic when you go in the studio.
Yeah, because you're thinking about it. But, you know, and cassettes are in again. Did you know that?
Do what?
Cassettes are in once again.
Well, I understand they've even gone back to vinyl. I mean, now vinyl album is selling for 30, 40 cents, you know.
Hey, listen, we found one of our albums. I've seen a couple of your albums down in Leaper's Fork at my girlfriend's new store.
Oh, really?
Finds in the Fork, yes.
Don't tell anybody how much they're charging.
They're a lot.
Oh, are they?
They're a lot, yeah. I mean,
tell her I got some more when she runs out.
Okay, I will. Well, I told her I was doing this today, so I
told me. Give me your name and number. I'll call
her. I will.
Well, listen, I understand you're going to do a couple of songs for us coming up. Something old and something new. So, folks, you won't want to miss this. We'll be right back. Hi, this is Ray Stevens with some great news. My CabaRay gift shop has gone digital. You no longer have to drive to Tennessee to see all the stuff we have for you to enjoy and buy. Take your time and take a nice long look around at all the ball caps, t-shirts, monkeys and squirrels. We have keychains, cups, mouse pads, and books, CDs, DVDs, and so much more. Everything we have in the gift shop is now available to you here online. So fill up that shopping cart. We told you we had something good for you, and here they are with special guest Molly Cherry Holmes, Baillie and the Boy, and Molly.
Wish I had a heart of stone, then it wouldn't hurt so bad being alone. Damn, I wish that I could build a dam to hold back the tears that flow on and on. But my heart's not made of stone, and my tears I can't control, 'cause my heart's so filled with love for you. Whoa. Heart of stone that you couldn't get through. Dreams, I wish I never had a dream, then I couldn't care at all that you didn't come true. But I cannot build a wall, and my dreams still don't come true, 'cause my heart's so filled with love for you. Wish that I could find a way, live without your love someday, then I wouldn't have to say, had a heart of stone, then it wouldn't hurt so bad being alone. Damn, I wish I didn't give a damn, and hold back the tears that flow on and on. But my heart's not made of stone, and my tears I can't control, 'cause my heart's so filled with love for you. Wish I had a heart of stone.
Wish I had a heart of stone.
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 Wish I had a heart of stone.
Stone.
Wish I had a
heart of stone.
I wish I had a heart of stone. Stone. Wish I had a heart of stone.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
It was a hit for us back in 1991, I think.
I was hoping you'd remember what year that was.
Well, here's one that's brand new. It's called The House My Daddy Built.
Oh, but hang on. I'm just going to put my guitar down
waiting,
real quick.
I'm waiting.
Michael and I have been married for 35 years, and I still put up with him. But it's okay.
She must like me tonight. She usually says, and three of them were good.
No, that would be 35 years, and five of them were good. That's okay. This is called The House That Daddy Built. Charming, charming story.
And the home my mama made. timber. Mama raised us kids. Some said we were poor, but our love made us rich. I wouldn't trade a fortune for the way we were raised. In the house my daddy built, and the home my mama made. I wouldn't trade a fortune for the way we were raised. In the house my daddy built, and the home my mama made.
Michael, thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Kathy and Michael, Baillie and the Boy. Stick around. We'll be right back. And Molly.
Ladies and gentlemen, Ray Stevens.
She comes on like a rose, but everybody knows she'll get you in touch. You can look, but you better not touch.
Poison ivy, poison ivy.
Look out, man, she's crazy. Yeah, she can really do you in if you let her get under your skin.
Poison ivy.
Chicken pox will make you jump and twitch. A common cold will fool ya, and whooping cough can cool ya. But poison ivy, Lord, will make you itch. You're gonna need a lotion of calamine lotion. You'll be scratching like a hound. Oh, the minute you start to mess around.
Poison ivy. Poison ivy.
Late at night while you're sleeping, poison ivy comes a creeping around. Well, now measles make you bumpy, and mumps will make you lumpy, and chicken pox will make you jump and twitch. A common cold will fool ya, and whooping cough can cool ya, but poison ivy, Lord, will make you itch. You're gonna need a lotion of calamine lotion. You'll be scratching like a hound. Whoa, the minute you start to mess around.
Poison ivy, poison ivy.
Late at night while you're sleeping, poison ivy comes a creeping. La 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 while back, one of my daughters was dating a rodeo cowboy. You know, one of those guys rides those bulls. And I told her to be careful, because it's not a good idea to date somebody that has the term bath night in their vocabulary. Or to date someone who doesn't know he has a vocabulary. She said she told him to be sure on and put fresh socks on every day. But he said that it didn't work out because after 3 days he couldn't get his boots on. It's time to dance, y'all. See you next time. Ma'am, would you dance with me? Watch your step. We'll give you the mic.
This is Bill Cody saying so long until next time from CabaRay Nashville.
Come join us here at the CabaRay. That's the Ray Stevens CabaRay and Showroom right here in West Nashville. We're easy to find at the Charlotte Avenue exit off I-40 West. It's the place in Nashville for a special entertainment and dining experience. There's great food, all your favorite wines and mixed drinks, a fun piano bar where you can sing along and dance. And there's the Ray Stevens Show, where I'll sing all my biggest hits with Nashville's best musicians and singers. So whether it's a special date night, entertaining friends and family, or you're just coming out to sing along in the piano bar, whatever your reason, the CabaRay is a fun place to enjoy a full night of entertainment. And the parking is free. So come see me, Ray Stevens, at the CabaRay. Call 615-327-4630 or go to raystevenscabaret.com. Make your plans now.